All right, boys and girls, today we're going to take a look at one of the world's most amazing aquatic creatures, the crayfish. No, but seriously, I've had the crayfish sitting in this room. It's a dark, quiet room, the perfect environment. They're not just walking around, though. They're in a bin with water and food, and the bin's covered. So I'm going to try not to be too loud, and we're going to just pop the lid off slowly and see what they're up to. All right, so we have the crayfish in this bin. There's a piece of cardboard covering it. And I'm gonna slowly pull the lid off. Hopefully this light won't be too bright or it scares them into taking cover. So here we go. Yeah, that guy just went and hid. So, right now, those two little things with triangles that you can see, those are kind of like the little homes. It's just like a plant pot that got cut in half, and they like to hide under there. When I pulled it off earlier, when it was darker, there was a crayfish under the right one, and apparently he didn't like the light this time, but we wouldn't have been able to see him either way. So maybe if I move one of these, let's see if I can just uncover it and see what he does. Okay, so there he goes. Yeah, he doesn't like that light. So you notice he was crawling forward. And now he's holding really still. And that's part of his one of his adaptations, his behavioral adaptation of holding really still, because a lot of predators like movement. So when he's still like that, he thinks that maybe a predator won't be able to see him. I'm gonna pull the other lid off now too. There should be another crayfish. Ooh, I don't know if you guys got that. I don't know if my camera caught that. But that one moved backwards. So they use their tails. And they want to move really fast. They flip their tails, but then they move backward. So maybe if I start taking some stuff out of here and kind of expose the crayfish. And there he goes. Oh, that one moved. Oh yeah, he's hiding in the corner. I shouldn't say he. I know one of these is a boy and one of these is a girl. I think the bigger one is the boy from what I remember. But don't quote me on that. So they'll do like an abrupt movement and then they'll hide. So yeah, crayfish usually in the daytime, they're doing what you see here. They're just hiding under something. And then they come out at night. And that's when they, basically, they eat whatever they can find. They're not too picky. They're omnivores. They'll eat alive things, dead things. I've just been feeding them these plants, and I can't remember the name. But maybe when I figure it out, I'll put a graphic on the screen that says what they're called. But I mean, you know, a crayfish that lives in the pond near stream near your house, they're gonna eat whatever they can. So like earthworms, dead fish, and then like plants and stuff. So they're good scavengers. And oh, this one's moving now a little bit. See, he's crawling forward. And then he stops. As you can see, this guy has two large pinchers called chelipeds. And crayfish typically use those if they're battling other crayfish because they're territorial. So you never really find too many crayfish hanging out in a group. They're usually spread out. And if it comes to mating time, you might have a couple male crayfish battle each other with those pinchers.
Oftentimes you could find a crayfish that are missing
one or even both chelipeds.
And that just means that they probably got into a battle and didn't win. The good news is those can regenerate. Crayfish molt, which means their exoskeleton is a hard shell. And as they grow, they start to get too big for their shell. And then eventually the shell will peel off and there will be soft membrane below it that will, after a while, harden back up, and that will become the new shell. So the crayfish, when they're molting, are basically they're growing. It's kind of like us when we grow, we get new pants.
Our pant size increases as we grow.
And get bigger and bigger. So that's what crayfish do. They're very vulnerable when they first molt, because the membrane, the exoskeleton, is not hard, so therefore they can get injured. So they're not very active when that happens. That's the most dangerous time for a crayfish.